Hey guys, it's Rooker Razor, and welcome back to my favorite 16 in the Liverpool program about where last time I left off. Oops. I went on a bit of a rant. And I talked with people close to me since then, and I've decided that from now on, there will be no talk of real-life football. No talk of real-life football, because when I play this career mode, it doesn't fucking matter or exist. It doesn't matter or exist. This is the only thing that matters. It's doing well. If this team, in this career mode, on FIFA 16, before FIFA 17 comes out, then FIFA 17 will be what matters. Real-life football, home, has outside videos, so my rage will no longer be directed at you, so you won't get any more rage about real-life football. Now, apologies if you really enjoyed the rage videos. Don't worry, I'm sure this game will make me rage and pull home outs. And I have no doubt I will be forced to rage it. 17, because there's always something, isn't there? You can't make a perfect game. So yeah, we're just going to talk about the game. And as you can see, I'm already into the match against Arsenal. Good block there by Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain to prevent Tillemans getting my shot away. Come on. Neymar! You prick! I would have gone to Coutinho and that might have been spectacular.
Keep the attack going.
Her goal. In any event. Yeah.
And it's now with Liverpool. Ronaldo.
What was I going to say?
Perhaps a better response from his teammates in the middle. The defender got.
Oh yeah, I was going to start talking about what happened last episode where I beat Chelsea. It was all around. And in terms of making progress and trying to win the league, that's a penalty. Thank you very much. Jackson. Heavy.
The penalty, I feel, is.
Where's his card? He at most got a yellow, or he didn't get one at all.
Everybody expecting that one to find the back of there. What a glory.
And I completely missed. What?
Decision is a throw.
He didn't get a card. He didn't get a card. What? He completely took Neymar out. But not only did he prevent a goal-scoring opportunity, which is a red card offense in itself, but the challenge itself is worthy of a red card. It was a bad challenge. It could have hurt Neymar. And he didn't even get a yellow. He didn't even get a yellow. So pretty much, that whole sequence was fucking pointless. Arsenal should be down to 10 men. And 1-0 down. The penalty misses on me. But that red card fail. That is a red card any day of the week. And last time I checked, Thursday was a day of the week.
Baratti. Lovely one-touch football. Well back! Hit the post! No.
Oh, I got extremely lucky. Well back denied by a double post hit. Yo, Arsenal wouldn't have even deserved it. Because they should be a man down and a goal down, let alone a goal up. Tillemans. Nari here. Nah. I did say this game might make me rage. It's starting to make me fucking rage. So if you didn't, you know, the rage of the last episode, good news, is FIFA's got you fucking covered. Cinemax. Lash it. Please tell me that didn't hit my own player. Oh, thank God. Simmons. Always seems to be waiting on the outside of the box. Maybe he should wait inside the box for the future. Bro, that was terrible. Don't take the ball, Cristiano. You just let it pass you.
Marco Reus. Neymar. Keeping the ball moving, that's important.
Ronaldo. Ronaldo got it back despite almost losing it. There he goes. There, now he lost it. And there's half time. So that was a preferably a fucking bullshit half. Now it looks like Newcastle will be going up into second because Chelsea have dropped so many points. And they're comfortably winning, you know, our Newcastle, so.
Baratti.
Far cry from their real life situation where they're in the championship. There they are, about less than 45 minutes away from going second in FIFA 16 in the Premier League.
EA Sports continues its coverage from the Barclays Premier League, the fixture.
Oh yes, Roy kept it in. I was actually be afraid he might have run out of play. I was half expecting the game. No. Oh no! The referee! He makes up for his your layoff off of a red there. Everybody not stopping the play and booking Tielemans. I probably should have been a yellow for Tim. And but he got away with it, fair enough.
Terrific stop. Corner here for Liverpool.
They get away with one, I get away with one.
Definitely an attacking.
Now it was only it's only down to my mistake that I missed the penalty. So hopefully we can rectify that. Bale. Can't fight Coutinho, it's knocked away. Hey, let me select the right player game. Yes. You shouldn't even be there. You're alright still. Despite him letting me off with a yellow card defense, he let them off with a red, so I'd have to get away with a normal for me to even consider us even.
Punched away by the goalkeeper.
Ronaldo! He missed! Cristiano! What? The fuck? How did you miss that?
Alan, what about Arsenal's next game? Yeah, they're playing West Ham United in their next match in the Barclays Premier League. I think
I was half ready to call a goal, but we missed.
This manager will be thinking about going into the transfer market if this carries on. So wasteful.
I don't know what to say. I'm thoroughly befuddled and bewildered. Good job to the man's winning the ball. Oh, go Cristiano, go.
Cristiano Ronaldo.
Good cross to make up for the miss. Neymar couldn't get there. Freaking Petr Cech.
Well, it's not the ideal conditions for viewing, but actually for
Rodriguez. Too heavy for Royce. It is time for a change. I think Ronaldo should be down to the wing because of that miss.
He surfaces stakes off defenders, chances for strikers.
He's scored a few goals already.
Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain.
In big situations.
Debussy.
As the next Chelsea player, I'm sure he would love to score against Arsenal. Here is Aquilante, and he does! He's barely been on the pitch! He's not even been on the pitch a few minutes. Only a few minutes in. And he's gotten the goal. Oh, masterful substitution. In again, ladies and gentlemen. And moving around is the way he instantly pays dividends as well. As he passes it to Royce, who is in cam. He passes it to Aquilante, who's just come up. And really, that was all of the changes in one. That was all one change. Because I moved Royce to cam, Ronaldo to wide, and brought on Aquilante. Empty for a slightly tired Philippe Coutinho, and boom, straight away it paid off. Ah, beautiful. And Arsenal must be livid.
They put that cross far too close to the goalkeeper. Down the wing, keeping the wide attack going.
That
didn't work, Alan.
Oh, wait, can Neymar get there? He is, he's gonna get there. Oh, come on! Actually, book him this time.
Position for the free kick.
There we go. After letting a yellow go forward against Tillemans and a red against Evan Martinez. Debussy, in the last minute, is finally put into the book for Arsenal. Which is weird, because he was actually sent off against me before. Someone else was put there. I think it was Olivier Giroud. Cristiano Ronaldo, can he make it 2-0? Straight at the Paracek. Not quite the Philippe Coutinho. What's that? Oh, that beat check in real life. And that will be my last time mentioning real life. Fit, unfortunately. But, what else fit was the ball in the back of the net as Neymar wraps up all 3 points. And everyone is going over to maul him. Oh, you can see Debussy, he was gonna go for a challenge, but he couldn't. He almost didn't want to risk it, it looked like. He kind of pulled out of the challenge, which allowed Neymar to get away, and for it to become 2-0. Considering I already missed the penalty, he was purely probably doing that just so he didn't get sent off. But, little good I did it, him because there's two dire moment goals was equal a 2-0 victory, and yeah, Newcastle beat Stoke 3-1, so they still won by 2 goals, but they conceded a goal and they scored another one, and that does indeed put them up into 2nd place. Joe Gomez would like to discuss his wages. I feel like I didn't put enough effort into Joe Gomez in this FIFA, and I'll be rectifying that next FIFA. Wait, where is he? I was looking at left back, I was like, wait, where is he? He's not an actual official left back, unfortunately. I will be changing him in FIFA. Yeah. Now, that's like the only modification I'm going to be making to the team come FIFA 17's releases that, well, he might already be down as a left back, but just in case he isn't, I will be making him one because he will be my backup to whoever I sign. Haven't decided that yet. So,
sorry, Belgium. And no dice. Not interested in any managerial job. Actually, first, the fourth. Hopefully I can get my goals much earlier in this second game. If I get a penalty in this game, and Cristiano Ronaldo will have to take it because Marco Reus missed in the first game. Yeah, no one cares.
The ball is rolling to start the first half.
You guys already. You can probably recite my team off by heart before you watch my videos. Unless it's the. Well, second team barely changed the leader. Unless there's a suspension or injury.
It's not a dull affair, this, because we've seen these managers set up teams in the past.
I'm very good at keeping the lineup consistent.
This is the Liverpool side. And Eric Laporte plays with Raphael Varane in central defence.
Which is made very easy by the fact that the two teams always play very well.
And Ronaldo. Liam Palmer. Here's Lee. He's cut out that pass. It wasn't an accident. He read the mind of the opponent.
Rodriguez.
Liverpool, a real spring in their step on the back of that home win in their previous game against Arsenal.
Good challenge by Palmer. He had to get it right, or this referee might not be as lenient as the one I had in the first game. To the man's. Win eight. The early corner of Halan. Smacked him right in the thigh.
Strong, powerful clearance. Gonna cross it.
Reus. They'll come back to Marco.
There's the ball in. They put that cross far too close.
Ah, Neymar couldn't meet the cross with. We got there first.
Top of its game. It's certainly been reflected in the results, and it's a run of victories, a massive run of victories that they want to extend today.
Well, you look at this team and you just wonder who is always through.
Marco Vic. Oh, I go away with it again. Another instance where the post has saved me up.
Possession changes feet.
Oh, and that's. That is going to be a yellow. It might even be a red. Yeah, it is. Oh. Oops. I pressed the wrong button then. It might not matter. Look at this. No, though. We can beat Palmer. We didn't. But, we didn't deem to have been fouled by Palmer. Kind of ran into him. Not sure how that's Palmer's fault. But, I'll take it. Lost a man, Bell. Oh,
it's a very promising attack.
Wait, what happened? Was that foul? Maybe Bell was just to a foul. Man, he
the tackle
kind of landed on after the header, but Concerned they had the ball anyway. You know, I don't think there was any point giving Sheffield Wednesday the free kick. They had the ball anyway.
I think Liverpool know they could
get more. Ronaldo. Coutinho. Surely. Yes. After her Sheffield Wednesday are probably robbed of a 1-0. He's just like it. It's Arsenal, but only earlier in the match. I take it. He pretty much, I dare say, an undeserved lead. Because I'm pretty sure that's my first shot on target. Yeah, unless the game counted that fatal header. It might have. Anyway, it is definitely.
Like the first goal came from Philippe Coutinho, who scores number 10. He's only the 8 behind Ronaldo and the 9 behind Neymar. I was going to say 8, but then I remembered Neymar scored that second goal against Arsenal. He's on 19. He puts him ahead of Ronaldo, really enough. Ronaldo behind someone for a change. I'm going to easily score. Rankings.
Liverpool leading, but it's
plenty of game time. And they want to get there for Ronaldo to get the golden boots.
Two more minutes to play of added time.
Three players will be buying for the right to win the boot for the second time, making a bit of 16 in history in terms of this career mode. So far, no one has won it twice. It's been won by five different people.
Can Liverpool replicate a good first half in the second period, which is now underway?
Well, 4 different people. Well, this is season 5. Tino, who has won it. Ronaldo, who won it last season. Ooh, almost level with Neymar, who's won it as well. The season before Ronaldo joined. And of course, Divock Origi, who is unfortunately no longer with the club. Won it in season 1, of course.
He got himself a goal to put his team ahead. He'll be pleased with that first 45 minutes.
Liverpool.
Yeah, I have a feeling that was a foul. I don't know why the referee didn't give it sooner. Oh, Melo with a bad miss. He rolled it past, rolled it wide. That was a really piss poor shot.
So long, the most successful club in.
You'd have to do better than that.
Try and get a league title.
I mean, it's looking good now. Are they expecting just because I'm down 10 that it's going to be easy?
They've settled into a shape. Who knows? Could be glory at the end of this.
Typified the competitive nature of this game, that tackle. It's only a throw in. Free kick here.
Oh, what? I can't put a little shoulder in? Shouldering is a. Is legal, or referee, official, or just playing. Look at a rule book once in your life. You can figure out, oh, my foul earlier was a ref, hey, but you don't know that shouldering is part of the game. Yeah, you're a complete fucking idiot. Card-wise, you were right to send Royce off. That was my mistake. But you made a colossal mistake right there, not knowing shouldering is part of the game. Epic fail.
EA Sports continues.
Oh, well, you want to give him a free kick for that there, too? Surprising. I'm going to point out every bit of shouldering from the how long until the end of the game and see if he calls any more as a foul. Unright, so.
Coutinho!
Oh, Coutinho almost doubled his tally and almost doubled the lead.
There
goes Matthias.
And this is it, the substitution.
Who ended in a transfer request at Sheffield Wednesday, but obviously no one bought him because he's still there.
Rafael Varane. Seba. Gonna cross it.
The ball. Oh, with a bit of shouldering, which again the referee he completely ignored this time. Was it just because I was super close to the goal? And we've actually he maybe built an attack that might have led to a second goal? Oh. Handball by Markovic. Don't give a pen. Oh! When I saw Markovic go down, I was like, no, do not do this to me.
Time is ticking away here.
Because this game would. This game fucking would. We all know it would. Uh-oh. Yes, Gareth. Go. Go, 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 go. Go, Neymar is completely away. Hey. Oh, he's not completely away. Okay, now he is. Cut it back. Coutinho! And the Brazilian boy seal it. Neymar with the assist. Coutinho with the brace. He's another 90th goal from a Brazilian this time. Neymar turns fire for the 90th goal. And Coutinho bags a second. Brazilian magic once again from the Brazilian magician. You gotta love it.
Just widen the margin here to
two. Well, unless you're Sheffield Wednesday fans. In which case, fuck off. Because I don't care. And there's the full-time whistle. Oh.
To their fitness and to their character, even though
oh. Sheffield Wednesday couldn't capitalize on the red card to Marco Rice. He's and Philip continues. Oh, he's means that despite the fact that they probably should have been 1-0 up 2 minutes before Rice was sent off. Seriously, let's look at this again. How the hell did he not? Near post, my keeper shouldn't be beaten at his near post, but thanks to his post, he wasn't. Their near post provided it a lifeline as such. And instantly, just after they got into second, Newcastle dropped points. Meaning they're probably not going to be in second anymore. What is the frick? What is... It seems every team is not interested in being second. I'm going to be... champions... by the end of February with the way teams are dropping points around me. The fact that I got super lucky twice in this episode. Yeah, Marco Royce will miss whatever game is after the Zenit game, which is... Norwich. He'll miss Norwich, unfortunately. Aw, oh, man, I wish I could not play him in the, choose to have his ban be the Watford game, because he wouldn't play that match anyway. In any event, let's just get past the Zenit game, because, well... Zenit game. Sim past it. And that will be that done. Both me and Zenit are through. Who this doesn't mean anything. The only thing that's on the line is PSV and Liga are both playing. And unless Liga get their first win, PSV are going into the Europa League. I think both teams are winless. That tells you how bad they've been. Oh, thank you for showing me the Europa League in Group A. I didn't ask for that to be shown, but okay. Thanks, that was interesting. In any event, no injuries. They beat me 2-1, but it doesn't matter. Aquilanti scored again. even in a simulation loss, he still scored. This guy has so many goals already. Hey, Chelsea, what were you smoking when you sold him to me? Yo, Chelsea lost again. They are down to 5th. Chelsea are out of the top 4. They didn't capitalize on Newcastle dropping points. They lost again! They have 5 losses! What? What is going on? Why is everybody dropping so many points? I'm not complaining, I'm just really confused. I don't know what's going on. In any event, and that will be the end of this episode. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe to the channel. Well, let me know what you think just happened in the comments, because I'm trying to think, and I have absolutely no freaking clue. I'm seriously completely dumbfounded by what is going on in the Premier League. Why is everybody dropping all the points? Why are they handing me the league? I know I'm the best team in the league, but, you know, put up a fight. You know, that's kind of the point. And to a league, I mean, you just don't give the title to the best team. That's not how it works. You have to actually try other teams. Well, we'll see if they can try in the next episode. Hey, Chelsea actually picked up a win. But they're still, they've only got up one place. Jeez. Thanks for watching. I'll enjoy it in the next episode. Until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.